Hi students, welcome back. Today we are going to learn a new chapter from our course book. The name of the chapter is Playing with Gorillas. Learning objectives of today's class. At the end of the class, you will be able to note that most of our perceptions of gorilla are mistaken. To realize that fear originates from ignorance, to understand that gorillas are playful but do not know their own strength. People often have incorrect ideas about gorillas. How much do you know about them? To check whether you got any misconcepts about gorillas, we can just do the warm-up activity. Try to find out the answers and you can give. If it is true, you can put a T. If it is not true, put NT. Let's see what is your concepts about gorilla. We will discuss it in our classroom. Now we can move on to our lesson. Most of people react to the word gorilla. They think of a frightening, aggressive beast with huge teeth. Many years ago, there was a film called King Kong, which described a huge gorilla running free in New York, crushing houses and causing mayhem. It finally ends up on top of a high-storied building and is shot down by an aircraft. We can see that in the introductory part of this lesson, some misconcept about gorilla is described here. Usually when we hear the word gorilla, the first thing that comes to our mind is an aggressive way, ready to attack, a beast which is ready to attack with a huge teeth which cause destruction in the town and all. When you heard the word gorilla, first thing come to your mind will be the movie King Kong. So here it said that the media has given a misconception that gorilla is aggressive animal to be feared. Now let's see what is the truth, real truth behind gorilla. Is it a scary animal? Do we want to afraid of it? This ridiculous story became famous throughout the world. It was a major cause of gorillas getting a bad name, which they really do not deserve. In fact, gorillas keep to themselves in the wild and are very shy, gentle creatures. They normally only get roused in the presence of animal from which they wish to protect their family. We can see in this two paragraph that gorilla is not an animal which should be scared of. It's really very shy and they are very gentle creatures, highly protective about their family. Now we can move on to the next paragraph. My first introduction to gorillas was with a guy, a famous gorilla in the London Zoo. The head keeper who looked after Guy was a very wise man with a great deal of knowledge about primates in general and the gorilla in particular. He had a very friendly relationship with Guy. He used to go into the cage and outer den to play with him, which astonished some of us. In this paragraph, we are introduced to a gorilla whose name is Guy. Guy is the name of the gorilla, which is very famous in the London Zoo. And a head keeper is there. Head keeper is very wise man and he got a very good knowledge about primates. That means a group of animals that include humans and monkeys, animals which live in groups. In general, they are living like that. So he the head keeper of the zoo is having a very good friendship with a guy. Guy means gorilla here. He used to go into the cage of the gorilla and they used to play outside the den of them. And not only that, if someone watch them, everyone will be very astonished. They will be surprised to see the friendship bond between this two, the gorilla and the head keeper of the zoo. Now let's see what happens. When I was fairly new to the zoo, I was taken by the head keeper into the canteen to enjoy a cup of tea while he explained his various skill with the primates and in particular with Guy the gorilla. When he told me that he used to play with this enormous animal, I was intrigued to know that he would do if the gorilla got angry or out of control. "Ah," he said, and went to the corner of the mess and produced a short length hose pipe which fitted nearly into his pocket. "What's that for?" I asked. "You see," he said, "gorillas don't like snakes. If I want Guy to stop playing with me, I simply produce this little piece of hose pipe, which he believes is a snake. He backs off immediately and leaves me alone. And I leave the den. Come back after feeding, sir, and I will show you exactly what I mean." I turned after feeding and the head keeper took me to Guy's cage, unlocked the door and entered. He walked up to the guy who offered his hand and they had a bit of soft play in the inner house. Then the gorilla rushed to the outside den and made it clear that he wanted to play outdoor with a head keeper. From this section, it's very clear that the characteristics of gorilla is given there, because it's very friendly with human. It's not that much scary, or it's not a fearful animal. Here, the gorilla is ready to play with the head keeper of the zoo. Whenever he went inside, he usually play with gorilla, and gorilla is afraid of snake, so he always keep a small hose pipe with him in his pocket. Whenever he want to stop the play of gorilla, he simply take it out and show it. At that time, gorilla will be afraid and he will go back to his own cage or den. In the last paragraph, we can see that how the gorilla and the gorilla is playing with the head keeper. When he offered his hand towards the guy, he just touched on it, and then the gorilla rushed to outside the den and made it clear that he want to play with the head keeper outside the den. So let's see what happened next. I arrived outside to watch the display. It went on for some time. I thought the play was getting a little rough, but the head keeper's pride would not let him stop. Guy had picked the head keeper up by his collar and the seat of his pant and was dusting the floor with him, apparently in fun. The keeper was out of breath and getting more than he had bargained for. He murmured in a low, loud stage whisper to me, "Get the hose pipe, get the hose pipe." So, how did Guy started playing with the keeper? Did it seem dangerous to the narrator at first? What made the narrator's opinion change about their game? What do you think about Guy here? We can see that they started to play. But after a little time, it became rough. Guy was using our head keeper like a mop and he was dusting the floor. The head keeper's pride didn't allow him to ask for help. But at last, that was maximum of his patience and he asked the narrator to give him the hose pipe. I realized for the first time that the head keeper had forgotten to put the hose pipe in his pocket and could not stop the gorilla. I rushed back to the mess and collected the hose pipe. I went to the outside cage and pointed it at the gorilla, who was now truly dusting the floor with the head keeper. It worked like a charm. The gorilla dropped the head keeper and rushed back to the inside den and refused to come out. The head keeper came out through the outside cage, looking pink and shaken and covered in dust and dirt. He rose to the occasion with great dignity, however, and turned to me and said, "As you can see, sir, I have a perfect understanding with Guy. This tale illustrates that gorilla can be quite playful and gentle, but they don't know their own strength." This is the conclusion of our chapter, that gorillas are very friendly, they are very human friendly, but they don't know about their strength. Here in the story, it's very clear that the guy don't want to hurt the head keeper, but while he was playing with the head keeper, unfortunately his play was hurtful to the head keeper. And at the end, our head keeper was not ready, that he don't know about them. With his pride, he says that, "You see, we got a good understanding. That's why I ask you to show the hose pipe. While you show the hose pipe, the gorilla leaves me, you know." So that is a big understanding between them. So this is all about the story. Oliver Graham Jones is the narrator of the story. He is a veterinary doctor at London Zoo for 15 years. During this time, he had about 6,000 animals in his care. It is no surprise that then he came across some funny case and lot of adventures. He wrote about this experience with great humor and knowledge. I hope you have understood today's class. This is a simple lesson about some misconceptions about gorilla. The narrator explained it in a humorous way. Very simple chapter. So thank you, students. Thank you for listening. Read it once again before entering our class